As Afghanistan stares at an uncertain fate, WION's Anis Malik is in the country reporting from the heart of the conflict. As the Taliban continues to make advances in parts of the war-torn country, the capital, Kabul, still believes that the forces can hold them back. More details in our next report. Take a look.
When the US troops started withdrawing, many predicted that Kabul would fall in 6 months. As Taliban continues to make rapid advances, the capital remains unperturbed to the violence surrounding it.
Life continues to go on with business as usual, despite the uncertainty that surrounds Kabul city. You never know when or where a rocket attack can take place. There was one earlier today in Kabul's PD-5.
Rocket attacks are not new for the Afghan capital, but in the last few months, there have been more and more attacks.
I'm standing in Kabul's PD-5 in Khushal Khan area and the Khushal Khan market, and there was a rocket attack just a while back. There were two rockets that were fired in this area, that is right opposite to the Marshal Fahim Police Academy. The rockets landed at a crockery shop. You can see the amount of damage and destruction that it has done. There are three people who are said to have been injured. The owner of this place is now clearing up all what has remained. There were cleaning operations, but if my camera person could show you as well, the rockets landed on these on the top of the shop. That's just made through the aluminium sheets, and it pierced through all the way down. There has been damage inflicted both to the property and to human lives as well. There are three people who are said to have been injured in this particular rocket attack. But this is not the first attack that took place in Kabul's PD-5. There was an attack or an ambush on a checkpost in another area of PD-5, the police district 5 in Sher Wali Khan, which was said to have been repulsed. This is the west of Kabul.
Security has been ramped up in the capital, but the Afghan forces remain confident. They say that they will be able to hold the Taliban back and recapture all the territories they have lost.
Attacks हो रहे हैं तालिबान सिटी की जाने तालिबान की जाने से काबुल सिटी की जाने तो ओवरऑल आप लोग कितना प्रिपेयर्ड हैं उनको रिपल्स करने के
इंशाल्लाह हमारा मोरल बहुत अच्छा है क्योंकि ये तो 20 साल से चल रही है लड़ाई वगैरह 20 साल से चल रही है जब अमेरिका भी था तो यही लड़ाई था जब वो लोग चले भी गए तो यही लड़ाई इंशाल्लाह हमारा मोरल टाइट है और जब डिफेंस मिनिस्ट्री से या इंटीरियर से हम लोगों को हिदायत मिलेगी तो इंशाल्लाह जो एरिया उन लोगों ने पकड़ा हम वापस इंशाल्लाह पकड़ेंगे कोई मुश्किल नहीं हम लोगों के लिए क्योंकि हम लड़ने में तो जब पैदा हुए तो लड़ने में पैदा हुए अभी भी लड़ाई है और इंशाल्लाह कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं हम लोगों के लिए
बट अवे फ्रॉम द कैपिटल द प्रेजेंस ऑफ तालिबान इज इम्पॉसिबल टू इग्नोर WION's Anis Malik traveled to Logar province, an area which is almost completely under Taliban control.
This highway behind me is a single track road on which traffic from both the sides is running. This highway is known as the Khost Kabul Highway. It connects Khost, the province of Khost, to Kabul, the capital city of Kabul. The premises where I'm standing is the premises of the province of Logar. The provincial capital of the province of Logar is governed by the Taliban. These rugged mountains behind me is where the Taliban are said to have absolute control. They have been attacking, they have been coming in down from these very particular mountains, attacking the Afghan army, attacking the Afghan security forces, and then taking their fair share or their share of the control over that particular territory. Where I'm standing right now, this is just off Kabul. It's Logar province. There are rugged mountains. There is not much development over here, but strategically, this is very, very important for the Taliban. For them to get to Kabul, or for anybody to get to Kabul from down south to the capital city of Kabul, this particular two provinces, the province of Khost and the province of Logar, where I'm currently standing, a complete authority or a complete control for them is absolutely necessary in order for a takeover of Kabul. Anas Malik, in Logar, Afghanistan, for VON, World is One.
In the latest development from Afghanistan, the Taliban has taken responsibility for the killing of a comedian in the country. Last week, viral videos emerged showing Muhammad, his hands tied behind his back and sitting between two men in a car, being slapped repeatedly. A Taliban spokesperson has claimed that Muhammad was an active policeman and responsible for the deaths of many people. The police refute this claim and say that the comic was never deployed in combat and was more of an entertainer for the checkpoint's officers. The terrorists had initially denied they had anything to do with his murder until the videos went viral. Muhammad was a popular comedian for his comic routines on social media and was known for his jokes and funny songs.
If Khashazwan deserved to be killed, he should have been put on trial in court. If that was the case, he should have been killed after being tried in court. This killing which has happened is unjustifiable.
On the other hand, a report by a US-based Washington Examiner Post has said that the Pulitzer Prize-winning Indian photojournalist Danish Siddiqui was brutally murdered by the Taliban. The report emphasized that Siddiqui was not simply killed in a crossfire, as was previously reported. Siddiqui had traveled with an Afghan army team to the Spin-Boldak region to cover the clash, and Siddiqui was in fact hit with shrapnel during an assault with the Taliban. He and his team went to a local mosque for first aid, and the report says that when the Taliban got to know that a journalist was inside the mosque, they attacked. The brutality of the Nazar Muhammad case and killing has now heightened fears of revenge attacks by the Taliban. This fear has driven thousands of Afghans who worked for the US military to apply for special immigration visas to the United States. The Taliban's offensives are also undermining their assurances that no harm would come to people who worked for the government, with the US military or the US organizations even.
Two killings in the past 2 weeks. One that has been claimed by the Taliban, the other that has not been. The one that has been claimed by the Taliban is of Nazar Muhammad Khasha, a very famous comedian over social media. The video clips of him being slapped by two Taliban members have gone viral. The Taliban spokesperson has said, or rather claimed, that those who were involved in this act have been arrested and they would be tried because that was against their orders. Khashazwa was later, after being arrested, was later killed in a more brutal manner. But that was not the first time. Earlier this month, we saw the brutal killing, or rather a heinous killing, of an Indian journalist. The Pulitzer Award winner, Danish Siddiqui, photojournalist associated with Reuters agency, was killed after his convoy was ambushed by the Taliban near Spin-Boldak. Details that now have emerged say that his body, that he was rather targeted and that his bullet-riddled body was returned. The Taliban have not officially claimed it, but the Afghan government maintains that the convoy with which Danish Siddiqui was traveling was indeed ambushed by the Taliban. The security forces right behind me here in Kabul are of the opinion that they would want to fight until their last breath in order to uphold the dignity and sanctity of their nation, and they refuse to give up. Anas Malik in Kabul, Afghanistan, for VON, World is One.
VON World is One is now available in your country. Download the app now and get all the news updates on the move.